Today on our show, we're going to be talking about India's quarterfinals, and with us to tactically break down and help us understand what the keys to victory are is former captain, coach and Olympic gold medalist Vasudevan Baskaran.
So question, against the Dutch, who will be the key cog for both teams, and who basically can they nullify each other?
Now for me, Manpreet is a very key player in for Netherlands, because so far I have seen him a different player, because he is in the name when the starting 11 starts, he finds his name in the back four. But he doesn't start at the back four, he starts at the front three. So that's one good thing happening for him, because he is a ball player who loves to play. He is not a good man-marking man. You know, he likes to expose himself with the speed, good stick work and all. That's one advantage for India. Use more Simranjit.
Yeah.
Use more Sunit. You know, because Sumit is another outstanding player. Use him more. And for that, the defense should be very solid.
Yeah.
If they're going up, there'll be a lot of space for the opponent to on a counter-attacks. So counter-attacks, India has to be very careful on counters. And you want to re-counter it, you need to be very careful. But I want our forward line to come into the game today, because they're not come into the game so far. I'm not criticizing what I thought, like Akash Deep, Dilpreet and Mandeep. Maybe I think they did do re-tackling everything, but that's not the job. Now in the current talk, the job is also re-tackling is good, but their job is to also strike the goal.
Finish.
So I think these are the key will happen for Netherlands against Netherlands. Netherlands also will have a different idea to come and how to mark Manpreet, or how to imitate him, or how to get him a yellow card. He has to be very careful on the card, because I know Manpreet is a very aggressive player, but aggressiveness, it has happened many times for India, where Manpreet was out 5-7 minutes or no. That's going to be very costly for us. I want some of the players like Harmanpreet, I'm not seeing much Lakra. I'm not seeing much of your Amit Rohidas. So I think these are key players will be used in a better way, maybe. And next is all.
But again, like you mentioned earlier, India have like 4-5 key players, and you are playing against a team which has 11 key players.
So I think that could be there with any team also. Like if you are collectively giving 60-70%, my always beg with the players that please give 70%. All players. I don't want any 100%. 70% you give, the team is winning.
Yeah.
If somebody is giving 50%, then I think you're only doing league matches level. So I think that's where we stand. Hopefully all the boys give 60% and above, and India should win.
So like you said, like there's these small moments, like life, hockey is also about incidents.
Yeah.
You have to match it in those small moments.
Yeah.
As simple as that. And you also brought up this like very interestingly, you spoke about Poland in 2000. Your assistant coach of the time is now the coach of India. You think, have you seen anything in him now? Like have you seen like an evolution in the way that he has perhaps learned from there? Is there anything?
Yeah, I think so. Because they finally see whatever he had learned from there, he was there about in the Asian Games also. Mm-hmm. But the players have to do what they want to do. Finally, I say the players have to do, they have to do.
The coach is not going to play.
Because play. But I think over the years, because he's been there for the last 5 years, as juniors, seniors, and all those things, Arindra has improved as a very seasoned coach. He knows where exactly the players are. He has selected a good side. And it's definitely good to see my good friend. First of all, he's a good friend of mine. And he is into hockey, like any other coaches in the world. He is breathing hockey, I would say, because he is always into the past games and the past performance, penalty corners, goalkeeper strength, all those things he keep collecting. I think that's how the coach has to be for India, because we don't have to. Because I was not a professional, I was a coach because I was a coach. Maybe I could coach rather. If I was a professional like Arindra, if I was a professional, then I would have definitely done better than. Now I realize.
Yeah.
If I had a lovely supporting staff in 2000.
But at that point, the entire culture towards coaching was different in any case. So most of the coaches who come for the national team, like you would have your regular department job,
then
take leave from there, come at the last maybe a 1 month camp or whatever, and then work. So Arindra has that luxury to work and understand the team like you mentioned. And so getting into India now and that the World Cup, So you mentioned earlier about destination and how. So India's destination is pretty clear. Actually, it's pretty simple now for India what they have to do. They have to win matches. They have to score. They have to win matches. So and they are play. They're most likely to play Netherlands in the quarterfinals. So as a coach and a former player who have been at the highest level, you understand what the pressures are going to happen. So what will it? What should India do? What does it take for them to now take the next significant steps towards a medal?
Well, I think the very important thing they are doing is that Netherlands is a very solid country like India in playing hockey at the highest level. Hockey is played in the world is Netherlands. The league is very of a high order, and all the players know collective hockey. You know, normally it's collective hockey is the team. So this is where the club teaches them at the club level. So most of the players are well equipped at the Netherlands. Not that India is not well equipped, but what India should do is that not allow them to too many spaces to go, move on. Because they're allowed to move with the spaces, Netherlands, because they have good stick work. They also have eliminating skills like India. But they have one better advantage is that they are good in striking circle and 23 yards line. They are there because that's where you get the ball to put there. So they realize 23 itself is a striking D. 23 yards, so they don't lose the ball there. So I think that's the strength of the Netherlands team and German team. But Netherlands team is much more capable of holding the ball much better. So I think Indian players should start against Netherlands. To me, is that don't defend more because it's a knockout stage. We have four quarters. It's an advantage for you. Decide what you want to have the first 15 minutes. You want to attack, please attack. Okay. Or you want to concede goal, don't concede. Now, I mean, it's easy to say from here, but it can happen. 15 minutes, if you try to lose the ball, then you will be having problem in second quarter, then third quarter. So 15 minutes, first quarter, try to dominate. You don't get a goal, no problem. You try to control the ball. Don't allow them to more room to play. Try and close them down, very close them down quickly. You know, the outletting should be very good. Indian outletting should be very, very good because we are good ball players. Simranjit, Manpreet, well, they are lovely outlet players. I think we have to use them very good. And this is where the Netherlands will have problem of doing that outletting passes stop by Manpreet or Simranjit. I think they are two key players for Netherlands. But for India, who are the key players? The entire team is key for Netherlands. We need to accelerate higher and try to be quicker on the feet. Because this is an awkward stage. We can't say a league match, you know, I can, you know, aram se khelega. You know, that's a sick, I mean, language I got. I know, aram se khelega, aram se nahi hota kabhi. This is there's no verbal talking about it. It's all quick, or fast you are. I mean, the quickness of that day against Netherlands will be the key for me. Because goal scoring, both are good. Penalty corner, both are good. Goalkeepers, both are good. But the quick fitted, passes quickly, how to eliminate quickly, and use the width of the game. Very important because Netherlands will use the width of the game because our wing halves are not playing steady hockey. Our wing halves are more attack good, they are to attack. But our wing halves will be tested that day. Because
that's true. Like Netherlands really spread the players very wide.
And they try to play the slip ball on the edges of the goal on the side because that's where the Europe team play now. They like play like an, you know, what do you call it? They play a lot of indoor hockey. I think that's where they get the goals.
Tight spaces.
And they go to end of them because there's no offside. So I think this is where I tell, you know, don't allow them to do anything on 23 or 25 yard line. Allow them to play upper on the midfield. So you'll be successful, but never try to miss chances because I want all my forward end to be there on the goal scoring chance. Don't say that every time we miss chance and I'm sick of it. Don't say after the game is over, miss chances. Oh, yeah, ho gaya tha. There is no miss in the other countries. There's no miss.
So actually, like this idea of like missing chances, like what is it? Is it down to basics? Is it just match pressure? What is it? I mean, why?
No, I think, you know, I think it's, see, after playing 150 matches, it cannot be basic.
Yeah.
It's a mental strength. You know, you have to.
So it is match pressure.
No, you see a lot of, you know, the top players in the World Cup now. Who are the scorers? The expected boys who are playing in the forward end to score. They only are scoring.
Not from the
blue. The people who are supposed to score, they are selected there for the team to score. That's why you have the team. So we have strikers in the team, so to score. So we have to score. So that's where the Indian team plus point will come. Minus point will not be there more because it's going to be a knockout match. I think Arindel will do a lovely homework with all the, you know, plus and minus. I think India have a 10% advantage over India because not worried about, don't go with the crowd.
Okay.
Don't play with the crowd. You lose the ball. You've done it before also in the World Hockey Series. You've done it one day before also. You play, you moved with the crowd the first two quarters. You played with the crowd. But you don't play with the crowd. Let them shout. Playing with the crowd is the most dangerous hockey in the world. Because you may have support, but you know, don't try to run with the ball. Don't try to, you know.
Playing to the game.
Yeah, don't run with the ball. You're not supposed to run with the ball because they're much faster than you. So I think these are things which has to be noted on the quarterfinals.
You mentioned that applies even if India progresses because the sides are going to be.
Yeah.
We might, if we cross quarterfinals, we might be playing Australia again. So there is no relenting in as far as intensity is concerned from now on. And Arendra in his press conferences have been talking about that. But you mentioned that India should take initiative, in say, as in go play attacking hockey. And so something like if they do, if a match situation arises in the knockouts, that something like what happened with Belgium, the first half India was invisible. So if that kind of initiative is given in the knockouts, will India be able to make that turnaround?
Well, listen. It's a good observation, but I personally feel in a knockout, that's a league match. Okay, when you could come back on third and fourth quarter against Belgium and get the two goals back, why didn't you do that in the first quarter?
Absolutely.
Why didn't you do that in the first quarter? When you got energy, when you had energy to do and you got confidence with the players, why don't you? See, my point is that four quarters is very good for any coaches to plan, any players to plan. You know, if you plan the first quarter, what do you want to do? Don't concede goal, try to get attack. You know, that's very important. The moment you do that, then they'll be under pressure. They'll have to change their options.
Absolutely.
They have to change, the opponent have to change their plan. So if you don't try to options to the players or the coaches to stop something happening there, then you are at loss. Hmm. If you try to have a lovely grip on the Netherlands team, then you should start attacking. Hmm. Now mind, first quarter, you don't concede goal. Attack means if you attack, you don't concede goal.
Yeah, fair enough.
There is a formula that you don't play full press.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you play half press. Snatch the ball, but don't allow them to play full press.
Yes.
So there are two issues. One is that they may try to play full press, or you have to play full press, but you don't play full press, you play 30 press.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You try to win the ball more, try to snatch the ball from the defender. I think these are the issues, small issues going to be a collectively important Indian team. Snatch the balls, release the ball quickly, passing skills to be very good. You know, don't be an schoolboy's error. I would say schoolboy error.
It has been happening in the
Sometimes you do schoolboy's error. Hmm. That is dangerous.
Yeah.
In a quarterfinal match, you know, you are not supposed to do a schoolboy thing. For example, in Asian Games, I don't have to hit the pass. You know, that aerial ball passes. It should have gone to the straight away to the 60 yards aerial pass. It came to your own half. That's a schoolboy error.
Exactly.
So I think these are the issues which 5-6 points, I think Arinder will definitely know about it. But I think you have to implement with the players. Tell them, give them confidence, you do this, allow them to play the natural hockey, they'll play better.
Okay. And as far as the team dynamics is concerned, you have observed these boys come up close as well. And probably you would have gotten some information while discussing with your with Arendra, your friend. What is the dynamics like? Like comparing it to your winning team. When you mentioned that you are a senior player and lot of youngsters who went on later to do great things for India. So, do India have that kind of a leadership presence in the middle as of now who can actually take charge and guide team when situation of pressure arises? Because that's what...
Naturally, yes, it's a doubtful for me to start about we are a dynamic person in the team. But we have only a captain, we can play Manpreet, who's a great player with attacking skills now. He's only playing the natural hockey now. He's not playing what he had about 2 years back.
Okay.
He was not allowed to play this hockey, where Arindel is allowing him to play. One, a dynamic team will be like, you know, to come up from the bottom.
Mm.
Number two is that, you know, at every given time, get together quickly. For example, if you say something is happening badly in the first 5 minutes, you try to communicate with the team that, okay, no, you have to wake up, jaldi ho jao. You know, all those things, you know, you can't stop the game and then communicate. That's called dynamic.
Yeah.
And then we need to understand what to do if you're getting a one goal lead. Mm. Where do you understand? How do you do it? Mm. But if you are getting, you know, one goal down, how do you restart the game? Mm-hmm. So I think these are the dynamic things is happening in the ground. In other games, you can always have a talk.
Yeah, yeah.
But in this 15-minute quarter, because you got two minutes to go.
Yeah, there's no time.
That by the time the players come out and listen and sit to the coach, it'll be 1.5 minutes only. So what do you do? So I think these are the situations where in that break, we need to analyze. That is where I want the coach to come in. Mm. Because players can't do that. 1.5 minutes, what first is that? Not to correct them.
Yeah.
Not to tell them what next option A, next B. Because in hockey, in most of the game teams, like, you know, the dynamic player in the ground may not be always a great successor.
Yeah.
So somebody will start shouting, but then somebody will not like it. Because the generation is changing. You know, in my days, generation was only shouting.
Yeah.
You know, it was, you know, I mostly played with Punjabi guys, and you know, they are all hard hitters, strong players, hard, very hard, the tackling is very hard. You know, the natural, you know, talk is that rakdo. You know, stronger, you play stronger. You know, these are the words, I mean, I came from. And now it's, I think this, not no time, we have to be very strong. All the players are very strong in the red time, because if we play quiet hockey, play soft hockey, I mean, I don't think we'll land up somewhere else. Mm. You needed to be very strong in the ball, very strong in deleting the players, very strong in tackling, very strong in man-to-man marking. You know, strong is a very important word again in Netherlands.
Mm-hmm.
In Europe, because the first thing, you don't get room to play. So, for that you have to be very strong, snatch the ball stronger, pass the ball stronger.
Mm.
No off, you know, Badana? Maravaka samba marra, like eating a dead snake.
Yeah.
So that all should not happen. These are the things I think I could only advise the players to go there.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.